battles of the First World War are filled with tragedy and lost lives. This is the story of the worst moment in Sussex military history. 1916, the day Sussex died. The tragic battle is now reproduced in minute details and available as an educational tool presented by its creator this week at Shoreham 4.
Well, I've been making models for years and years, and I find it quite therapeutic, gives me some thinking time. And quite a few months ago, Amanda Scales came to council and put in a request that we remember those that fell from the Royal Sussex Regiment at Boar's Head with a memorial. And as I was sitting there, I was thinking, maybe I can recreate this with another diorama, which is now what I've done. And then you think, what do I do with it thereafter? I've made two before, and they were on display at Patcham Library. The children enjoyed them. We sold them at auction, and the money went to Patcham Memorial Hall, which is related to the First World War fallen. And then someone said, why don't you come to Shoreham Fort and bring it here, and then it can be on permanent display and people can see it and perhaps visualise what actually happened on that momentous but tragic day. On the 30th of June 1916, and at 3:05 in the morning, the whistle blows. And when that whistle blows, all the men from the Sussex Regiment go over the top. And this represents that exact moment that that all happened. The reason we say the day Sussex died is the Sussex Regiment's from local people, probably people that live in the village I look after, now as a councillor, died on that day.
Yeah, Shoreham Fort is actually a Victorian fort built in 1857, but what you're stood in today is actually a First World War Nissen hut, so we'll be able to do grenade training and that sort of thing in there. It's going to be a real hands-on experience for those kids, but at the same time they can see exactly what it was like on the front line with Lee's model, so it's a huge asset to us.
I think these sort of models do actually put it in a 3D perspective. It makes it a little bit more real, and particularly for young people. I think our young people, I learnt at Patcham Library and at the school there, the young people sort of like the sort of realism of it. And because it's small and intricate, it's the sort of thing we all remember making Airfix models, and they look at the same thing. And I think it gives it that new dimension than just reading books and being told about it. I use reference books, I watch videos, I go to the library and get details, and then I'm very comfortable that I've got an absolute accurate reflection of the trench on the day. And I think actually the detail is what's really important here. So for example, those that will care to look at it, they will find, for example, that I've actually found on the internet the newspaper of the actual day that I've scaled down to the exact size, and I've left them scattered around on the floor of the trenches, and just to add that little bit of realism.
This is William Neary for Latest TV News.